We have to keep Big Boss's body out of enemy hands, no matter what. Get the body safely to the canal escape door.
enemy dead ahead.
Is never done.
Big Mama.
Where's the van? Children. No. She'll be coming to search the van.
I'll take care of it. You stay here. Keep watch.
I'll contact the children.
Here. Take this.
Snake. Come back in one piece.
I will.
Promise me.
Something's coming! Run, Snake! Run!
Thank you. feel the anger building up inside. Eating away at me.
Way to bring that bird down, Snake.
Drebin.
And you got yourself a souvenir, too. A grenade launcher. Nice. That's a real user-friendly weapon.
Not much use to me without an ID, though.
I laundered this one free of charge.
What's the catch?
Only that you give it to me when you're done with it. A weapon with that many decades of rage stored up inside it? Now that's a collector's item.
How old was she?
I'd say about 20. But she had years of soldiers' rage hidden away in that youthful body of hers.
Soldiers?
Yeah, the soldiers of Ake. A place that hasn't seen peace in a long, long time. She was captured by one side or another. and kept caged up like an animal, along with God knows how many other kids.
Anonymous violence.
Exactly. It's unknown whether her captors were with the government or the rebels. In any case, they got their kicks by abusing these helpless little kids day after day after day. That constant barrage, that battlefield rage slowly built up inside their bodies, their minds. The kids tried to keep each other's spirits up, always clinging to the hope that someone would come to their rescue, barely surviving off of scraps of food. But those soldiers didn't stop. They called the kids parasites and shit-eating ravens, beat them even harder. Then one morning, the soldiers just up and left, leaving the surviving kids to be eaten alive by the birds, almost like one of those sky burials. One by one, their bodies were picked apart by ravens' beaks, until finally the flock came for her. But by some miracle, their beaks cut her bonds instead. And like that, she was liberated. In that instant, she was filled with an uncontrollable rage, and it smothered her soul. She ripped the ravens pecking at her to pieces, and then went after the soldiers. And when she finally caught up with them, she waited until nightfall, like a hunter awaiting its prey. They say that when a raven cries, a man dies. And that's exactly what happened that night. Screeching and cawing, she killed every last living being in the camp, both the soldiers and the civilians they'd enslaved. In her eyes, there was no longer a difference. The cruelty her friends had suffered, the pain and humiliation she'd endured, hers was the distillation of the rage that decades of war had imparted on those soldiers.
It was her strength and her greatest weakness.
You're something else, Snake. You managed to cleanse Raven of her rage. No, seriously. You're the seed of war. In fact, I'd say you might even be war itself.
Draven?
Maybe it's still too early to tell. You still got half the B&B Corps ahead of you. Keep your eye on the ball, pal.
Snake, I have to apologize. The three vans that came out with us are decoys. The real one is floating down the river, headed downstream. I managed to get in touch with the children. The Pix is safe. We're going to rendezvous on the riverbank, downstream. Land and air routes are cut off. Oh, but there's a cruiser waiting for us. The Volta River is our only chance of escape. Oh, let's get out of here. Hurry.
Good thinking.
I don't need to feel the wind anymore. There's no need to keep lying to myself. I only get off my bike when I fall in love. Or... Oh, Snake. Give me a hand.
Yeah.
The underground aqueduct leads to the river. There should be fewer of them down there.